Good. I'm live on that one. All right.
I can't even see your head. I can only just see.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so we're live on YouTube now. Okay. Hello, everyone. And I'm just getting live on Facebook, and then we're going to start building this base for this dinosaur. Just got to go live here. And okay, so I'm now live on my Facebook page. Gotta share it. Okay, so, alright. So we're live. Okay. I'm just going to my Facebook page. Hello, everybody. Sorry, I'm just trying to set this up. I'm just trying to share this video so I can get as many people watching it as possible, and then we'll start. And I have no sound. Okay. I don't see it yet. Hold on. It's not live. Is it still live up there?
Yeah.
Sorry guys, just having trouble connecting to Facebook. I'm trying to make this live simultaneously. Okay, so just bear with me for a minute. Let's try this again. Paste. Alright, we are live, and hopefully my internet is working for this. Just sharing this video. Testing 1, 2. Making sure my sound's working. Alright, let me just share this to my own profile. No, I want to share it as myself. So let me go back here. Alright, so I can see now. Alright. Sash, can you see if there's people watching on that one?
It says zero right now.
Okay, good. Alright. Okay, good. We got people watching. Okay, so what I'm going to do right now is I want to make a base for this dinosaur. So, and I've got a nice wooden base right here. But I want a diorama on it with plants and rocks and stuff, so I'm going to actually make a base out of this piece of styrofoam. So, and I've got a new product to try. It's this Aves Cliché. It's a powder that you mix with water, so but before I do that, I got to match up to the base here. We don't want it all the way, probably kind of like that. So we need an X-Acto knife. We're gonna cut like that. We wanna get our size first, and then we'll cut it down after that. We'll shape it. And the thing is, once this is carved out and we put the clay sheet over top of it, it will become very hard. Like, kind of like if you were doing it with plaster of Paris. So, this is the first video I've actually done in my garage, because it works a lot better, so I can face the laptop and actually see if people are leaving comments and stuff. So, as I'm going along, if you have any questions, please let me know. And hopefully everyone on YouTube can hear me too. I'm trying to do this live simultaneously between both things. So I've got...
So David Clark just shared your video.
Nice. I got my buddy Sash watching my phone because I can't see it. So I got people sharing and stuff. So thank you for that. So, all right, so we got basically the size that we want right here. So now we're going to kind of carve this base out so it looks like rocks. And then when we're done, then we're going to attach it to the wooden base. So hopefully everyone can hear me on the Facebook Live. If you can't hear me, let me know. I'm actually just going to type that in case people can't hear me.
I think Casey said your vid keeps going in and out of focus.
Okay. I'm just going to type here. Question mark. Hopefully that posted. Alright, so what I'm going to do is kind of carve this on an angle a little bit. We don't want to in too far because the dinosaur is pretty big. This is a Saltosaurus, so he's going to go on a little bit of an angle so he doesn't even fit on here. So pretty much I just wanted to do this video, kind of show you basically how I do it and to try this new product out. So we're just going to carve this up here a little bit. Styrofoam's awesome because it's cheap, it's easy to find. Pretty much any kind of appliance you buy, you can just save the foam and use that. You can also get big sheets of it from Lowe's and Home Depot, and you can get actually sheets of this white styrofoam, which is pretty cheap. If you were to go with the blue styrofoam, it's a lot nicer for carving, but it's also a lot more expensive, and you don't really need it for this stuff. You're just making a simple base. So just gonna mix this up a little bit. I don't like that edge right there. And this X-Acto knife is pretty good for getting in detail. It'll cut smooth and stuff like that. So
Casey says move the camera up or down a bit so it can stay in focus.
Okay. So sorry that my camera's bouncing in and out a little bit. So yeah, leave it, try right there. That looks good. It just keeps trying to focus on, and I think it's changing from the foam and then trying to focus on me. So anytime I lift it up or move my hand. So
is this going in and out of focus a bit? Maybe just move your camera either up or down so it stays, because it's
we just did.
Out. Yeah, okay. Thanks. Alright, so
Wayne Carrier. It's
first time trying to film this way. I'm trying to make better videos, so I wanted to use my garage, but I have the 920 webcam from Logitech, so it works good, but with the autofocus, it sometimes tries to...
Your dad just commented, I think, said, looks good, sausages.
Alright, so that's pretty much all I want to do here. I don't want to do too much for this one, because I'm going to let the plaster that I'm mixing up do a lot of the sculpting work for me. We can form it into rocks or dirt or mud or whatever we want. So give me a minute here. I've never actually used this stuff before, so I'm kind of excited about this. This is a new product, and I'll just kind of set it at the base of the camera so if anybody wants to look it up while I'm using it. Now, I did read on the box that you can mix this into different thicknesses for smearing it on, so I'm actually going to move the base out of the way, the wooden base. And then I'm going to take this cup in here and mix. So I think we probably about that much is good. So and then we're going to grab a little bit of water. I don't want to do too much water at once. So I think that's probably enough water for now. And I'm just going to grab a big stick over here to start with. This stick's a little too big, but You'll have to use it. The thing about doing live videos is that you try so hard to think about everything that you might need, but you usually forget one or two things. So, I might have to get something a little smaller for this in a minute. But that's actually mixing up real nice. Don't want it to drop. You can see that right there.
Oh, my comments popped up, but they just faded off.
We'll do that over there for the YouTube video. So we'll keep mixing this. This stuff's pretty good so far. I used to use just straight plaster of Paris and water, and I'd mix some wood glue in and some sawdust and kind of do it that way. But this stuff I like better already. It's it's mixing a lot more like a clay actually. Thanks, buddy. Yeah, that's perfect. So, just want to make sure we mix it good so we don't waste any. Gotta set him out of the way because my stick's too big. Alright, so. I like that. That's a great mixture. I'm going to use this big stick and smear it on. We can also water it down later to kind of make a thin coat over top if we want to. Actually, I think I'm just going to add just a smidgen more water in there. Just get it a little more wet. So, but like I said, so far I like the consistency of it. What I want to do is really see how well this stuff sticks. And one thing I can say is that Aves is known for good products. I've been using their epoxy sculpt for a few years now, and it's great stuff. It works good for fixing up the resin kits and any models and stuff like that. So we're going to set that off to the side for now. I'm going to move the box out of the way now. Set that down. Okay, now I'm going to smear it on here. I'm going to take a bunch with the, and I'll probably work it with my hands too. I don't really care. I know they're going to get messy.
Miramad just commented saying what species you're working on.
Oh, the dinosaur is it's a Saltosaurus.
And is that a prosauropod down at the bottom of the screen? What'd you say what it was?
It's called Saltosaurus. Okay. Are they talking about this one? Are you reading that from Facebook Live?
Or I'm on YouTube Live.
Okay. Alright, yeah, it's a Saltosaurus.
Nothing's popping up on yours, and it's just it just pops up and then fades away, so.
Oh, okay, you can't see it fast enough? Alright, yeah, it's
How much does that stuff run for, she asked, that stuff you're spreading?
That I am not certain. Actually, I should have looked that up before I, I actually, got this with a bunch of other stuff as part of, trial, so I'm not sure, but I don't think it's too expensive. The epoxy sculpt is pretty reasonable. Like, I'll show you guys quickly this stuff here. This is usually about $40 Canadian, and I think that's
air dry or bake? She asked.
Oh, this stuff, it's air dry. Yeah, it'll dry. It says it sets in about an hour. But it can take a couple of days before it completely dries. So you don't have too much time. So I'm going to use my hands. I can always just go clean them off before I do the second part. So after this, I'm going to do, I'm going to start an armature. So I figured I'd just quickly do that too. Because with this video, I won't be able to do the entire process of this because of the drying time. So, it'll need to be painted and stuff later, which I'll do a video when this is completely dry, and I'll give some final thoughts on this product. But so far it's great. You can see it's smooth on there, very good. I could have made it even thicker than this actually. So yeah, it's really good stuff. I actually tried an air dry clay made by Polyform, the same people that make Sculpey, and it was pretty good. The problem was is that it shrinks and then starts to crack, and you don't want that. I mean, for what I did, it actually turned out okay because it was like a desert kind of scene, but I mean, normally you wouldn't want shrinkage or cracking. You know, that's just not good, and you certainly couldn't sculpt with it. I wanted to use it as a base first, and if it worked good, I was going to try sculpting with it, but I found out pretty quickly that there's no way that you'd ever be able to sculpt with it. So, alright, let's just get this down.
She says I used Sculpey for the last three dioramas. I did pretty good. Marble shrinks a lot when it dries.
Yeah, if you use bakeable Sculpey for a base, that would work too. The problem with Super Sculpey for bases is that it's expensive. You know, it's like, I don't know in other parts of the world, but in Canada, Super Sculpey for a 1 pound block can run you almost $30 at Michael's. So that's, to me, that's a little much to spend on that. If you're doing, 30 or $40 for a large bag of this and you're doing like 10, 15 bases, that, to me, that's a lot more economical. So that's why I would go with.
I used a wooden plaque for the base, made the dinosaur Sculpey. Hold on, let me just. So I didn't catch that.
You just gotta make sure.
She used a wooden plaque for the base, made the dinosaurs out of Sculpey. 1 pound at Walmart is about $6 American.
Wow, six. Even with the exchange rate, that would be. That would be super cheap, $6 American, wow.
She says she needs to look that stuff up.
Yeah. Well, next time across the border, I'll check it out. Is that original Sculpey or Super Sculpey, though? That's because I know original Sculpey, sometimes you can get it fairly cheap. And actually, you know what? That wouldn't be bad to use on a base. It's not too bad. But I certainly wouldn't want to use Super Sculpey, just like I said, for the price. Now, for all my sculptures, I use Super Sculpey. Actually,
she's going to grab the box that she got it in and read it off quick.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah, I'm interested to know. All right, that's looking pretty good. I have to go over it once it dries. So, the next thing, and I'm sure people are wondering, is why would you want it to look like you're running your hands through it? Well, we're going to fix that in just
a pound of original Sculpey, now they have multicolors of it, but it's in a smaller pieces and more expensive.
Okay, so it's original Sculpey, well, still $5. Original Sculpey is, I think it's like $18 or $20 here for a 1 pound or 2 pound, I'm not sure, but it's certainly not very cheap. Okay, so I'm gonna just put some water on my hands. I'm gonna take this old brush, just kind of go over it a little bit, just to get that smeared around the base. So once this is got its proper texture and it's all done and glued to the wooden base, we're going to put plants and stuff on it, just a few of them, and you can grab those anywhere. Actually, I got these.
I made three dioramas, one for the Triassic Apatosaurus, still working on it. And my daughter and I made a T-Rex, and I made a Stegosaurus one.
Oh, wow. That's a lot of sculpting. That's good.
The other two represent the two eras of the Mesozoic? Mesozoic, yeah.
Oh. Wow, that's good. Yeah. Put this in there. It's too sticky to do this, but you can use rolled up tin foil, and if you just roll it around, it can create like texture, like rocks and stuff. It's a little too sticky for that, so we're gonna just not do that right now. We'll smear it.
The plants were made from craft felt. I made the cycads and scales trees from Sculpey, as well as the Calinatelles.
So sculpting.
Tackleys, sir, turtle, and the horsetails from painted cocktail toothpicks.
Oh, that's pretty good. That sounds pretty talented. I've seen a lot of people doing sculpting the trees. I'd like to do that. I've never actually done that, but you know, actually for this dinosaur right here, another way would
We do a lot of upcycling.
A tree with it. That would have been cool, but the diorama isn't, unfortunately this diorama isn't quite big enough. Another thing too is I can leave this fairly smooth, and I can
and pom-poms for little bushes, actual gravel
come back for rocks. And I can glue rocks and stuff to this, which actually works good, and just actually use sand from the outside. It works good as well. So there's all kinds of different ways that you can do it. So I'm just gonna see. I've actually made quite a bit extra, so I didn't really need to do that. So I'm gonna pull some of it out, and
gonna have to try sculpting a base.
Yeah, if you're doing large dinosaurs, then Abe's epoxy sculpt is good for the lower layer, because it creates strength, and then after that you go over it with your Sculpey, and it saves it from cracking. Because I know when I used to sculpt with Super Sculpey, I'd get a lot of cracking, but now that I used the Abe's epoxy sculpt first, it creates a layer of strength. So I'm gonna throw a little bit more of this on, just in different spots. Bunch it in, just so that the ground's more textured.
Yeah.
So it works better having somebody read the comments off me, because like I said, I can't see any on YouTube. I don't actually see any on the my Facebook Live either, and I'm not sure why. I'll have to just wash my hands up and click on that and see why I'm not getting any comments on it. It says there's three of them, but I can't see them, so I'll have to check that out in a minute. Just gotta get this stuff off my hands, so I'm just gonna put this in a little bit better spot there. All right, let's clean this off.
Putting any plants on the final model, or just the animal and the base? Either way would be sharp.
Yeah, pretty much just the animal and the base with a few small plants. It's not going to be too elaborate. So usually I don't go too crazy if I'm just doing one dinosaur and a base. If I'm doing more than one, then I usually add more to the base. So I'm just gonna clean my hands. The other thing I actually forgot to bring out, which was really silly, was paper towel. I'll just clean my hands off. So there we go. It's not the best, but
Hang tight, I'll get you the blue roll.
Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna texture this some more. And what I'm actually gonna do is put the dinosaur's foot in here lightly. It doesn't really matter because I can wipe the foot off later. Put this in. Another thing too, just because I couldn't roll the tin foil in there right away, I can do that maybe in about 15-20 minutes. Perfect thing, but that's good. There we go. It's messy stuff, but it works really good. It covers well. So I'm gonna set it. I'm just gonna wipe this stuff out of my way. Then I'll go in there and I'll sweep it up. Clean it off. So I'm gonna move this out a little bit. Peel it off. I'll bring it forward, and then I'll do the tin foil. Probably in about 20 minutes or so. So the other thing I need to do is this base, because it doesn't look too nice just plain wood. So I'm going to quickly stain it. So I got this golden oak color, which is pretty cool. I'm just going to shake this up. Pop it open. Once I'm done this, then I'm going to start building an armature. I'm not going to go too far with it. And just give me something to start and then finish it later. Oh, that stuff stinks. But it'll make a real nice color. Sometimes I just paint them black. Cool thing is too that you can finish the whole base, glue it onto the wooden base, and you could actually mold and cast this and use it multiple times or for different dinosaurs. You can just add different plants to it. So it's, I just lean in and check something here. It's showing comments, but I can't see them. So I'm just gonna flip over here. See where the comments are. Weird.
Rodri Enron says, wow, nice.
Oh, thank you. Well, here we go. I think I can get to these comments. Oh, here we go. Now I can see them. Okay, good. So you can see them, Sash? Can you see the...
I'm on my Facebook right now. Like, I'm on your Facebook.
Oh, okay, good.
On my phone.
Yeah, it certainly helps having someone else read the comments off.
Hold on, it's just not. It's going live, but okay, so it's probably.
There we go.
There.
Alright, so that's all we need of that. I'll make sure you're just better than I did.
And I just gave you a like.
Oh, nice, thank you. I like the likes.
What is the wooden base here for? Oh, sorry, I must have ordered that. I said, what was the wooden base there for?
The wooden base?
Yeah.
Well, it's just, it's going to go underneath. It's going to go underneath the base that we just made.
To give it some stability.
Yeah, give it stability. And it just kind of makes it look nice. You know, it's going to look more professional. when it's sitting up on someone's shelf.
It's a lot better now.
Yeah, just putting that little bit of stain on it makes it so much better. I just gotta flip back to the actual video.
Sharp, that'll be slick looking. I can see Adam, that now.
He's watching right now. Give it a quick like. All right. There we go. So I can see. Now you can see just throwing that stain on it made it look so much better. So we're going to brush. Problem is, table gets messy and then things stick to it, but you can see how much better. This looks so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to lift this back up and see this, and I'm just going to set it on the base. That way I can just see how it's going to fit.
Taking it to put more around there?
Well, I don't want that there. No, it just makes it easier so I can see what, if there's any spots that are missing. You don't want to punch it out now. There we go. Oh, I shoved it over too far. It kind of got a little bigger than I thought it was going to, but that's okay. Let's just see how it... There we go, see? Not too much, just a little bit of... Going to pulling it up. So. Alright, so that's basically what it will look like. So I'm just going to set that down. We'll check it as we go along. And then there's one other thing I want to do before I end this video. I'm going to wipe some of this out of the way. There's another thing in the center. Throw that in the water, so we won't need any of that stuff. Just gonna scrape this off. Alright, now, next thing, I'll show you this little skull here. I'll go right in here, see if I can get up there. Yeah, it won't do it, it's too blurry. Anyway, that's a 1/15 scale Ceratosaurus. Hopefully it's going into the YouTube view as well.
It's pretty dark when you get to
know. Yeah, I know, it's kind of dark. So
right there I can see it.
Yeah, there we go, that's kind of perfect right there. So people are watching it on a bigger screen, they'll be able to see it.
Oh yeah.
So this is part of an armature, because if you want your sculpts to be more accurate, then you want to sculpt the skull first. So, and here's a skeletal.
Ceratosaurus, not something you see every day.
So, what was that?
The Ceratosaurus, not something you see every day.
Yeah, it's not sculpted near as much as it should be. It's a pretty cool dinosaur. So you can see when I lay it down here that the skull matches the skull on the skeletal. So what we need to do here is start making the armature. I've made these in videos before, but I try to do as much live as I can. So I'm just going to show you these little blocks that I've cut out.
Yes, I made it by Frederick Alexander.
Yes, that's right. He did make one. I saw it. Yeah, and it was awesome. Yeah, I really liked that one, actually. And I remember that...
And then Myron says Frederick would love to see a pic of it.
Yeah. Well, I'll take pics and post them in the comments on the Facebook Live and the YouTube. I don't know if I can post pics in the YouTube, but I definitely will on the Facebook Live. So, but yeah, I'm going to cut some pieces of wire here. It's important to follow these skeletals, or even if you can get go to a museum and get a profile view of the actual dinosaur, that's even better. We're going to cut this down a little bit more. And then we're going to use the drill. We're just going to drill some holes in each one of these pieces of wood. There we go. Beautiful. Oh, good, that one. Okay. I'll actually do this guy, see where this is sitting. So we're going to do it down about here.
What color scheme are you going with?
What's that?
What color scheme are you going with, Myra Mad?
When this guy's painted? Ooh, that's a long way down the line. I haven't really thought about that yet. I like the sideshow color scheme. I think it's great. So I don't know if I'd copy it, but maybe something along the lines of that, I think would be cool. So you can see here that, and now this is, oh sorry, there's the, that's the torso. So then we got to do another. We're going to get some more cut off here. Use it to another. I'll try not to move so much, because every time I move, that's when the camera on the Facebook Live feed seems to go bad on us.
How do you go about making the armature in separate pieces by Frederick Alexander?
Oh, like this with these wooden blocks, if that's the question you're asking? Or do you mean like making the legs separate or the tail separate?
It's all he says is, how do you go about making the armature in separate pieces?
Well, if I
especially the head and limbs.
Okay, well, if I wanted to do that, there's two ways to do it. The first way is to make the first layer with the Aves epoxy sculpt, and then I would slice it down the tail and the neck, or the head and the legs, wherever I wanted it separate. I would just do that before I did my final layer, and I would use...
I never thought of an armature. Next time I'm going to try that, I think, by Myra Mad.
Oh, yeah. Armatures are all... This right here is strength, for sure. But, yeah, if I'm going to do that, I'm going to slice it after I've done my epoxy sculpt layer. And then when I need to sculpt the final layer of the Sculpey, then I'm probably just going to tack it with a couple pieces of super glue, sculpt, bake, and kind of know, then I'll know where the line is, so then it's easy to cut it again for the final molding and casting process, you know. And I guess that's all depends on if that's exactly what you're going to do, if you're going to mold and cast. Now this is a little loose, so
you're going to use that wood in the whole final piece.
Oh yeah, yeah, the wood, well the wood just stays inside of it. Yeah, so yeah. So it doesn't wood never goes out of it. And it doesn't matter, because what I actually use to cut my sculptures is let me just see. Oh, that's too short, so good thing you realize that. What I actually use to cut my sculptures and make these blocks and everything is a scroll saw. So if you can ever get your hands on a scroll saw, I would suggest, you don't need it, you can cut them, you know, You can just cut them with a little hand saw. Like I have a little, what, a coping saw and stuff that I use. But you can, the scroll saw makes it a lot easier. And then I recently got a, like a bench sander. It looks like a belt. And then it's also got the little spinny thing on the side. And that's how I sanded the edges of these blocks and kind of made them the shape of basically the hips and the shoulders. Okay, so let's try this again. This time I'm going to put it in this spot first. Then I'll fold it down. One thing I can see, oh no, there we go. That's better. I am going to have to shave this down. This corner's a little too high. But that's okay, because we can always modify. And I find the best thing to do when you're bending this wire is make sure you follow the vertebrae. Okay, so I gotta flip back over to my other things. I can hear comments on this one.
I'm just all on your YouTube right now.
Yeah, no, that's good. You can keep going from YouTube. For some reason I can't see. The other day when I was doing this, I could see my comments, like, no problem.
Something popped up, but it just...
Yeah, they go away fast sometimes. So, just so everybody knows right now, I'll explain this. If you want me to answer questions and I haven't seen it during this video or whatever, you can just...
So your sculpts don't rely on things like pegs and peg holes to attach separate parts.
Well, no, I don't. I do use, and I wish I had a piece to show you what I do. Like, if this was bigger, like with the Yang Trenosaurus I just did, what I do, like, I would put these brass tubes in here, and then I'd make my head and neck wire. Like, I'd have the skull, and I'd have the wire, and then I'd have a little bit smaller brass tube, so it slides in and out. So then I can, what I was going to explain, actually, that the second way to make armatures in different pieces is to use brass tubing. You'd get, like, two sizes, and then they fit into each other. So if I was shaping the legs, I would do the shape of the legs, and then I'd turn them inward, and then I'd put the smaller brass tube with some epoxy sculpt in there. And then I'd use the bigger brass tubing and slide it in so I can take the leg on and off whenever I need to. So I can bulk it out with tin foil and masking tape and then put it back into the spot. So that's how you would do that. And I will show that kind of armature in a later video, like an armature that where you can take it apart and reassemble it and stuff. And it works really good, especially for anything larger. I wish I had something that I was working on where I could show you that. So the last part we're going to do is the tail here. We're not going to do the legs on this video.
Well, that's genius.
Oh, well, it comes from researching and seeing a lot of stuff that other sculptors use. You know, so that's why I do these videos, because I know that when I was trying to learn how to sculpt, well, the first time around when I was a teenager in the 90s, there wasn't even, YouTube didn't even exist and stuff like that, and I did have to get some books, but even when I started sculpting again in 2011 and started researching, there wasn't really that much out there, like, for YouTube videos and stuff like that, especially with dinosaurs. It wasn't, there's people that sculpt them and stuff, but they weren't really, it wasn't really broadcast or anything. So as I started to learn, I kind of made this deal with myself where I was gonna start making YouTube videos and showing other people kind of as I learn, you know, because it's frustrating when you're trying to learn something and you want to learn so bad and you just can't learn because, you know, you always can learn, but it takes you longer to learn something because of the fact that the resources aren't there that you need. So, now, a couple of these pieces are a little loose, so I'll have to hold it up like this. So there is your, and I'll go like this, so hopefully you can see it from that angle as well. So that's basically, and then I'm going to quickly do one more thing just to show you. I'm going to use the epoxy sculpt so you can see. So it's a two-part. You don't need very much. Actually, this is probably enough. You got to make sure you have equal amounts. So what I do is roll them in a ball. Too much of this one, so we're gonna rip some of it off. Oh, gotta have my Tim Hortons coffee.
I want a lettuce burger.
Yeah.
I've been watching you and some others picking up chips to my own style. So thanks for sharing that. Most appreciated. And then Casey, maybe he wants a lettuce burger.
Well, when the live video's over, we'll go get a lettuce burger.
Okay, just for you, Casey.
But, yeah, that's good. And you know what? You learn stuff, and then you take the sculpting even farther. You know, you get tips from me and other people, and then you take it further. And, I mean, there's some awesome resources out there now. One of the best is Stan Winston's School of Character Arts. You can... I mean, that's just endless learning right there. I love it. I've watched quite a few videos from them.
Thank you. Good job on the vid, guys.
Oh,
Casey.
That's good. So, yeah, it's going good. It's a learning process.
Got his channel subbed by Myra.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, please like and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you can. Check out my Facebook page, Dinosaur Dungeon. The YouTube channel is called the same thing.
Greatly appreciate you doing these videos like that. It's a great help for me by Frederick Alexander.
Oh, you're welcome, buddy. Your work's awesome. I love what you're doing. Okay, so, two things quickly before we go. We're going to use some Insta-Cure. Now that, I'm going to take these pieces are fairly tight, so we don't need to do it. But this one's kind of a little loose, so we're going to just throw a little dab on here. I'm going to put it back. We're going to leave it sit for just a second. I'll mix this up some more. So, sorry I can't see the comments, but luckily I got my buddy Sash here helping me read them. So if you guys have any questions, we're going to wrap this video up probably in the next 5-6 minutes. So just
if you get a chance, I know you're busy, but if you get a chance, check out my dioramas. I did some videos of them and I loved your take on them.
Yeah, sure. All right, well, leave me a link in the comments to where I can see them and I'll definitely check them out. So I'm going to continue with the diorama in a later video. I'm not sure exactly when. So this is pretty good now. So the last thing I like to do, just to make sure, is we're gonna put some Aves epoxy sculpt. Now this Aves, you can use this for usually a couple hours. It has different properties depending on the amount of time. So right now it's really kind of sticky. It's kind of like an adhesive, like a, what do you call that, a plumber's epoxy. So it's not really that sculptable right now, but if you were to leave this sit for about 30-40 minutes, it actually gets really nice, like a nice sculpting clay, and then you can do detailed work with it. And that's something I should do in a future video is explaining how to use Aves to modify and customize sculptures. Actually, I'll just hold this guy up. And if you look at this foot here, it was actually bent too far forward.
Bring it down a bit.
So here, I'll move it down. Bring it towards the. Sorry, get in the light. Make sure everyone can see it. It was actually bent down too far, and so I cut like a wedge in it, put it down, and then used the epoxy sculpt to re-sculpt the skin detail. So that's stuff you can do too. Like even with this, when this is molded and casted, I probably will cut the legs, and you know, if I want to make a scene with two or three of these guys chasing a sauropod, I can customize it.
Oh, your battery's dying.
So, no, that's fine. Well, we're going to shut her down soon. Yeah, that's the one thing about using cell phones.
I'm shutting her down.
It's going to be good old Willy. Just a minute.
What skill is your Ceratosaurus in, by the way?
Oh, the Ceratosaurus?
Ceratosaurus.
Yeah, this is a 1/15. I usually make them, so say the Ceratosaurus is 25 feet. So I'll go 22, 23, make it a little smaller, and a 1/15. That way the people who collect 1/18 can get it as well. I try to do...
Big Boy by Frederick Alexander.
So I try to do it so that people in at least two scales. Sometimes I try to sculpt things in a 1/18 so that the 1/15 and the 1/20 guys can collect them. It's kind of hard. I mean, you can't...
I can't wait to see the finished one.
I mean, you can't please everybody, because I know a lot of people collect at different scales. Some people won't go over 1/35 scale. Some people
Jason, 120. That was Wonderfest. Did you have fun with Vinny, Chris, and the boys?
Oh, yeah. Who's saying that?
Let me pull that on my phone here.
Wonderfest was awesome. It was great. We got to see Shane's dinosaur table. I'm sure.
What Willie Colt with CCMA? Wet Willy CCMA comment that asked that.
Oh yeah, it was awesome. Wonderfest was awesome. But anyway, yeah, Shane's dinosaurs were there. I'm sure most of you who sculpt dinosaurs know Shane Folks. He's the owner of Cretaceous Creations of America, and he's been doing this for a long time. And I actually learned how to build this armature the way I'm doing it right now by taking a class from him in 2013 that he did at Jersey Fest. So, shout out to Shane for that. That's what I mean. If you look around, there's lots of people teaching stuff. So we're not going to put... actually, we will. We're going to put a little bit more in here.
I got Shane's resin Tyrannosaurus skulls recently.
Oh, nice.
Frederick said that.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You were using... Yeah, I got that for the... actually, part of that class, that's the same skull we were using in that class to learn how to build these armatures.
Planning on using it for a Tyrannosaurus sculpture.
Oh, good job. Yeah, I got mine. I got halfway through
it. It's Bill Garner. Shane does awesome dinos. I love seeing your channel doing this.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Yeah. Yeah, there's a few good dino sculptors out there now. And very nice people. That's the thing about Wonderfest. You see all these amazing sculptors, but they're the nicest people, and they
don't come along, buddy. It says Wet Willy CCMA says you have come along, buddy. I think he says you may have come along.
Come a long way. Yeah. Oh, thanks. Yeah, it's every sculpture gets a little better. So, all right. So, I don't want to touch the head, even though it's loose right now. So. But you can see, looks like he's about to turn his head and roar. Kind of gives you an idea for the final pose. Now this, see, I can move the tail, I can move the neck, you know, move the head around, get an idea of what I want to do here. So I'm not going to do the legs completely, but I will show you quickly how I will do them. So I'm just going to cut a piece, we'll do the one leg, And then we'll end it there. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the next couple minutes. So I take the wire and I place it on the leg right here at the top. But I want to make sure that I leave wire above the top of the leg. I actually don't need that much. Probably just there because it's a theropod, so the hips were kind of narrow.
Are you producing your own kits or is Vinny cast them for you?
Vinny did some for me, but right now I'm actually learning to do them, to do molding and casting on my own. So, but yeah, Vinny's been a great help, and he's kind of explained some of the molding and casting techniques and helping me out with that too. Yeah, Vinny's been a great help. He's a good guy.
I remember when I was over at your house the one time that you were doing that, like in the garage, your aunt's garage.
Oh yeah, years ago. That was my first time sculpting. Unfortunately, I didn't. That was my first sculpture, but I actually sculpted for about 5 years in the 90s, and that was up into the early 2000s. Thing is, I didn't take a picture of anything. That was an Allosaurus. It was beautiful. It was huge too. It was like a 1/13th or 1/12th. Like it was big.
Who's
was like
Vinny? Might I ask?
Vinny is a molding and casting guy. So, yeah, he was just one of the molders and casters. He's done a lot of good work for a lot of different guys.
I remember that. Remember that Brachiosaurus broke. Oh, no, it wasn't Allosaurus, I think. It fell and then broke. The head came off.
Yeah, that's the problem with the Sculpey, right? So, then that's why I use this epoxy sculpt, because when you use straight Sculpey, it's so brittle. It's very brittle. So, looks like my video tapped out on my Facebook Live. Is that one still going?
Yeah, still going on that one.
Okay. Good. I'm still here.
Awesome casting is fun. Did he show you how to hollow cast?
He does. He has a rotocaster machine. But I still learn the gist of it. He explained it, and I watched some videos on it. I actually do my torsos by hand. The Shunosaurus is the only kit that I've done on my own, and I rotocast it by hand. The 65, I think it's, oh no, it's 57D that I'm using, smooth cast. And it sets up in like enough that you don't have to spin it after like 5 minutes, I think, so I don't have to do it for too long. So anyway, here's the leg. So the reason why I left it over the top is because I had to bend it inwards. You can see there. So that's the leg. If you're looking at it from the front view, there's the side. You can see the actual shape. I left it longer down here so I could pin it into the base. Just usually use an old 2x4 to pin it into. And what I would do here is I put this back on, and I can kind of see where it goes, and I'll just use this to mark it. So roughly there is where it would go. So there's a hole, we'll take the head off. I need to drill right through, but I'm not gonna bother. So I hope everyone can see this on both video feeds. And that's basically what you would do. Slide it in. You can readjust it from there. You do the same thing, put the Aves. I'm not going to do that right now because I'm not exactly sure what I want to do with this dinosaur yet. So he's probably going to sit for a little bit. And I'm going to try and use this guy as my live video. So you'll pretty much see all the progress with this guy. So that's what I'm going to do. For him. So, and that's where we're going to end it. So I'm going to check this before I go. It's still pretty muddy. It's not, it hasn't actually really changed its
How long does that take to dry anyway?
Well, it said that it sets up in about an hour, but it can take up to a couple days. So, and you can texture it like this too, by the way, which is just by pushing straight down on the...
See, I wouldn't even buy that quick drying stuff anyway, because it just...
No, this stuff's the This stuff's good, and you can, you know, who cares if it takes overnight? Does it matter? That's why I
think it's a lot better, actually.
I usually have like 3 or 4 projects always on the go. This is actually not my studio. It's downstairs. Like right now, there's a Yang Trinosaurus on the molding casting table. You know, I got another sculpture going. I got Wendy Ceratops that's ready to be molded and casted. I've got a couple of busts to be painted, which I'm going to do some live videos on that. So I got a lot of things on the go. So if this is drying, it doesn't matter. I go to making an armature or to doing something else. So there's usually lots of things you can do to spend time in there. So anyway, one last thing. If you're watching on YouTube, please like and subscribe. And if you're watching on...
Thank you once again for making this video. Look forward to your progress on the sculpture by Frederick Alexander.
Oh,
battery's
thank
getting
you for
too.
Watching, buddy. Thank you for watching. So yeah, go to my Facebook page, Dinosaur Dungeon. You can see more of these. I'll try to do them more frequently. If I can, I'll try to make more YouTube videos.
Thank you for sharing this. Keep up the great work.
Oh, thank you. Thank you everyone for watching. Have a great night. And we'll post a new video soon.
Good job. I will try to keep up. Finish?
Yep.
Are you sure you want to stop streaming? Yes.